Hi. So here we've got some real vectors in Rn, and we've got m of them, none of which are the zero vector, and we're told that this set is orthogonal. So that means, well, ortho means right, gon means side of a polygon, but really we're talking about angles, so right angles. So these vectors are in some ways, in some sense, at right angles. And the sense that we're talking about is that if we take the dot product of two of these, any two of these, that we get zero. So the dot product of any two of these is zero. Now, if we have such a set, then apparently it's linearly independent. That's what we have to prove, so let's prove this. So, proof. Now, there's a standard way to prove that vectors are linearly independent, and that's by looking at a random or an arbitrary linear combination of them, like this. So there's a linear combination of these vectors, where these lambda 1, 2, up to lambda n are some real numbers. We don't know what they are, but they're just real numbers. Now, what we're going to do with this linear combination is suppose that it's equal to the zero vector. So let's say if, then something happens. Now, what we want to prove is that each of these lambdas here has to be zero whenever this linear combination is zero. There's only one way for this linear combination to be zero, and that's exactly when all the lambdas are zero. And that's one way that we can then show that S is linearly independent. So that's what we're going to do. Now, the way that we have to do it is use the information that we have, which is that we have an orthogonal set. So that was the bit about the dot products. So we can choose any of these vectors here and take the dot product of that vector with the left-hand side and the right-hand side and then see what we get. So let's do that. So we have... So the left-hand side has been dotted with Vj. The right-hand side dotted with anything is just zero. Okay, what then? Well, let's have a close look at what we have when we take the dot product into the brackets and dot each of these individual terms by Vj. So let's have a bit of a grammatically awkward sentence. So we have lambda 1, Vj, and a whole lot of terms, right up until we have lambda m, Vm, dotted with Vj, and all of this is still equal to the zero vector. But let's look at each of these individual terms. If j is equal to 1, for instance, then we have V1 dotted with itself. That gives the length of V1 squared. And since we're not dealing with any zero vector, then that's a positive value, not a zero value. I think I've forgotten the 1 there. Cool. And in fact, that's true for any of the terms here. So whenever we have a V something, where that something is not j, then those two vectors, the V something and the Vj, dotted together will give zero. So in fact, all of these terms are zero except for one, and that's the term where we have Vj dotted with itself. So we can write that. So lambda lambda j dotted with times Vj dotted with itself, which is Vj and the length of that squared. So if you look at what we've got here, we've got lambda j times the length of Vj squared is equal to zero. That should be the zero number, not the zero vector. So we have lambda j times something that's positive is equal to zero. Well, that's only possible if lambda j is actually zero. So we could write thus, lambda j is zero. Now, what is lambda j? Well, lambda j could be any of these lambdas here. J could be 1, 2, 3, up to m. It doesn't matter which one we chose. This conclusion is correct regardless of which j we chose. So for all j from 1 to m. And in fact, now we're done, because now we've shown that if we have a linear combination like this, which gives the zero vector, well, that's only possible if all of the coefficients here are zero. And that's one way of saying that S is linearly independent. And that's the proof. So just to make the proof nice, we could write it up. So hence, S is linearly independent, and we are done. Thank you very much.